about 7 million people cross the border here in Niagara County from Canada into the United States. Is a lot of people. It's second only to Kennedy International Airport as far as the amount of people who leave Canada and come to the United States. On occasion, fugitives in Niagara County will attempt to flee to Canada. I think a FirstNet application with this, with public safety broadband, would give us the ability to track these people down.
We do frequently have cruise ship passengers who wind up becoming ill on their cruise ships. And the nearest hospital is about 150 miles away in Whitehorse, Canada. And so we do have ambulances from Alaska driving 3 hours to get to a hospital in Canada. And if ultimately the Canadians built out their equivalent to FirstNet to be able to transmitting EMS data about the status of an individual to a hospital that's so far away, and you know, I think that could save somebody's life.
FirstNet is interested in what's going on in Canada, and we're equally interested to see what's going on in the U.S. because when something bad happens, borders don't matter anymore. We're working on both sides.
It's been terrific to see Canada work very closely with the United States and looking at the exact same band 1420 megahertz of spectrum across Canada as we did in the U.S. And the amount of coordination and collaboration between our countries, I think, is, you know, unprecedented. I think that we've really been pushing industry. We've been pushing the public safety community to really embrace, you know, not just public safety broadband, but also looking at spectrum issues and making sure that our cross-border issues on the northern border between the U.S. and Canada, I hopefully believe will be very seamless going forward.
Data travels so fast and gets out there, and first responders don't have the data available to them. The biggest issue is not going to be the technology that happens to get this working across the borders. The biggest issue is going to be the governance structure. Industry Canada is talking with FCC and NTIA to ensure that everything works properly across it. And I think we will get to the governance structure that makes this work well, and that's where the governors come in. That's where your states and your SPOCs come in.
So having both border agencies being able to communicate with each other on the ground and in the air and across different kinds of incidents, I think is invaluable.